Okay.
Okay, fellas. Yeah. My good friend, Buddy Pal Chums, from Slice Bread Slices. You know how you sweat when you're in a hot environment?
Right.
Do you technically sweat when you're taking a hot shower?
Sure. Why wouldn't you?
But you just don't feel it because you're already wet.
Yeah. Or it gets just, like, wiped away immediately by water.
I was taking a shower this morning. I'm like, huh? Do I sweat?
You're like that one account on Tumblr, shower thoughts.
I actually like this.
Yeah, it's good. I'm not saying he has bad content. Or she. I don't know who runs it, honestly. I mean, they're pretty funny most of the time, too.
Do you sweat?
Do I sweat?
Do you sweat?
Do you sweat?
Excuse me, do you sweat?
Oh, she got a better yeet stick.
Yeah. I got a better yeet stick for Kazan and Sarah, and I got a lance for Chester. But I still kept the spear, so you can do range attacks, though, if you wanted to.
Cool.
Cool.
Do you sweat in the shower? Leave a comment below.
Right now, I can switch to the lance. The spear.
So do
spear.
Do you like cold or hot showers?
Hot showers? What are you talking about?
My showers feel more comfortable, but I guess if I wanted to wake up or something, I would do a cold shower.
I just, like, I don't know. Why wouldn't you want a hot shower?
Well, some people do cold showers because A, it wakes them up, and B, it makes them, like, 10 times more alert, and C, it's apparently even better for you.
I mean, I guess. I get that, like, hot water or whatever would make you sleepy to some extent. Man, he is weak. Look at his HP already, he's almost dead.
Because this boy's a strong boy right here. Mm-hmm. And he's not very defensive.
Why didn't you make him run?
Because it gets XP, and that's gonna be John Monster.
Well, I guess he wouldn't have gotten out of his reach anyway. Mm-hmm. Alright, anyway. I guess it makes you hot showers make you sleepy and stuff, and don't wake you up as a cold shower would, but it's also at the same time, like, Water in general would wake you up.
That's true, yeah.
Like
you were splashed hot water in your face while you're sleeping, you're gonna wake up.
Yeah. if I'm in my bed and my alarm goes off and I walk to the shower if I get wet in the next 5 minutes, I'm not going back to sleep.
Mm-hmm. Doesn't just feel better.
Yeah. Like it feels soothing, like a hot shower feels more soothing.
Hot shower at the end of the day.
Mm-hmm. Especially like during March, it always feels great to take a warm shower after that. Mm-hmm. Even though I always like tell myself I'm gonna take a cold shower because man, I'm hot. But when I'm home, I'm not hot anymore. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
It always annoyed me when games like this would like say, oh, so-and-so dodged your attack, but in the animation it just looked like they blocked it, you know?
So Pokemon,
basically, is what I'm saying.
Or when they do nothing.
Well, it's different when they do nothing. Well, yeah, so, like, in that case, if your Pokemon does your attack, and it does its animation, and then it switches over to the Pokemon who's being attacked, and then there's no animation at all, and it just says this Pokemon dodged it.
Well, so Pokemon Stadium.
Yeah, there's no dodging animation. They just missed.
Mm-hmm. And you should just say it missed.
Yeah.
Exactly.
I just wish they would keep it consistent, because it's like, well, is dodging different than missing?
Yeah, because I'm also that picky.
Yeah. Thanks. Thanks for making me seem like more of an asshole.
Yeah, you're welcome, bud. that's what I'm here for.
Are you able to see any of the, like, enemies' movement capabilities?
No, not really. All right. I just have to remember. Actually, well, they have a movement of 7, which means, like, the higher the number is, the more I know they're gonna be able to move farther.
Yeah, they move 7 spaces.
And I don't remember all the stats of that, but like, different races or different classes have like this like have a certain amount like bonus to what they can move in certain land. Like in planes, plain biomes are like zero land effect areas. I know that like centaurs can move pretty far on them.
Mm-hmm.
But in forests and like deserts, I think they suck in those. So, yeah.
I know I'm just gonna keep referencing it this whole series, but in the Kingdom Battle game for the Switch, you can like. You have your curse with your cursor. You can like look to see where your enemies can go,
mm-hmm.
and it's just real helpful. So you can like just be out of their reach if you wanted to hit them. You know,
mm-hmm.
it's all about that one's a whole lot about positioning, as is every fucking strategy game like that. Now that I think about it,
yeah.
Now that I think about it, aren't Fire Emblem and, like, that XCOM style of game kind of similar? Or
yeah.
are they basically the same genre?
It's... I think the main difference, granted, I've never really played a whole lot of it, and I've only seen you guys play Fire Emblem, but I think the main difference is that, like, in this type of game in Fire Emblem, you have to go right up next to them and then engage in that little skirmish thingy.
Yeah.
Whereas in XCOM, there's cover and you have to have like line of sight to shoot them, that kind of thing. It's like a whole 3D environment as opposed to just like a map you're on.
Mm-hmm. I mean, Fire Emblem, especially the newer ones, have similar stuff like. There can be blockades or, like, healing pools.
Yeah.
And that kind of stuff. Or, like, spikes. That kind of stuff. Which makes it, I guess, even a little more similar to XCOM or Kingdom Battle. But, I don't know, I just thought of them being similar games until, or not very similar games until you brought it up.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, I don't know. I honestly don't play enough strategy games, and I'm starting to play more.
Don't you have Awakening?
I do. I played it for like maybe 2 hours. I mean, they were 1 hour sessions, but I played it for about 2 hours, and I just never picked it up again. I don't know why.
You got bored.
So you got a number like it was like you got it at Christmas, I think. And yeah, I also got like other games as well, like
mm-hmm.
like Legend of Zelda. Again, I think I got Majora's Mask, didn't you?
Yeah, I got Awakening, Majora's Mask, and I think that's also around. I didn't get them in the same like immediate time, but that was the same time I also got Monster Hunter 4 Ultimate for the 3DS. But yeah, I knew I would more consistently play. Majora's Mask, so I just... That's why I didn't play Fire Emblem. It's not that I got incredibly bored. It was kind of weird, though, because I'd never played that kind of thing before.
Mm-hmm.
And it just kind of throws you in. Which is not incredibly bad. It was just different for me.
Alright. I understand.
Yeah.
Like, sometimes when I... Like, that's one thing about Christmas that I usually try to avoid. Like, the reason why I guess I kind of... I guess technically... I shouldn't have to worry about this, but like sometimes I don't get like a whole bunch of games for Christmas because I know I won't play all of them. I'll just stick to one game and play it.
Mm-hmm.
But I can just save the game for the future, I guess.
Yeah, well, that I feel like that's a very common issue among gamers in general. It's like, oh, I have nothing to play, but then you actually have this backlog of games
mm-hmm.
that you have either only played for 20 minutes. Or haven't played yet, and you just haven't had enough time to, like, sit down and get into it.
It's also just about, like, interest, too.
Yeah.
Like, have you even developed into this game yet?
Mm-hmm. Nintendo is normally very good about making their games really accessible, so it's like, in the first 20 minutes, you can decide if you're actually going to like the game or not.
Mm-hmm.
Jinx! Give me a nice second.
If I said Jinx, you did it.
Or I owe you a nice second.
There you go.
I think that's less true though for Fire Emblem, just because of the type of game it is.
Because
I still don't know if I'll like it.
You just gotta, like, once you actually get into, like, the big, like, story plots, that's, like, in Fire Emblem, that's usually when you start getting interested into it.
Yeah. You know, I've started caring less and less about story.
You just wanted to get into the gameplay?
Yeah, I mean, I can appreciate a good story, I just don't find it absolutely necessary.
Yeah.
Like, I like it a lot when games, like, have their gameplay as part of the actual story. Like, I know I made a joke about it earlier, but, like, consider if actually in the fiction of this world that when people died, they either exploded or faded out of existence like that. And, like, there was an actual reaction to that. Or maybe, I guess they wouldn't really react to it if it was normal.
Because that'd be life.
Yeah, but just, like, stuff like that. Like, oh shit.
Wow, it's like getting to the mages in this, I mean, the healers into this game now. Really, like, where I don't kill, like, get them down fast enough, like, I'm gonna kill you, then all of a sudden, look, I can heal them.
Nice.
Yeah, it's just, I like stories that integrate. Like, I think Hollow Knight will do that a lot. I haven't played that yet, but I plan on getting it soon.
You see, like, for me, games, for me, I really love the stories of games. That's the main reason why I usually play them. Like, I like the story of this game. It's pretty alright. It's pretty good, I guess.
You're one of the... Well, I forget the fucking names now that I'm about to reference it, but you're one of the three types of... The three reasons you play video games. For the... One's for, like, the community, one's for the, like, story and the characters and stuff, and the other's for gameplay.
I think I'm just all of those.
Yeah, I mean,
like, I like a lot of those.
Honestly, nobody's just, like, one, you know?
Yeah, like, for me, the main reasons why I play a game is definitely, like, story and gameplay. Community, I don't care. There's usually ways I can, like, things I can do to, like, not look at the community or listen to the community at all.
Real quick, can you hit, like, your guys by accident? I know you said
no.
There's no friendly fire, but...
Nope. Okay. Unless if, like, there's a spell that some enemies, like, have in the future called Muddle, which basically makes my own people attack each other, like, if the spell works against them.
Gotcha.
And he dodged my attack, because he's a skillful warrior.
By blocking.
By blocking, of course. I'm honestly just, like, combination, I guess, community and mechanics. Just because that's kind of why I like Monster Hunter so much, because you can talk to people and fight at the same time, and it's real satisfying.
That's probably why I'm a huge fan of Mario. Everybody's like, oh, it's the same plot over again, Bowser steals the princess or whatever. I'm just like, fuck you, who cares? It's a Mario game. It's supposed to be for gameplay and tight jumping.
After closing time, maybe we'll talk more about this. Or maybe